So I got a knock on my door the other day and exploded in excitement when I saw that my comics had finally arrived in the mail.
That is 22 boxes of comics. 1,500 comic books. Finally got them in the mail, and also my hair is no longer pink. I dyed it back to blonde. Anyways, I got the packages in the mail, and so I'm gonna open them up and flip through some of these books. It's a good day today. Let's open up one of these boxes and take a first look at this comic book. Definitely well sealed. And here we have it, Requiem of the Crazies. I gotta tell you, it feels great to actually be holding in my hands this comic book that I've been working on for years. I put a matte finish on there, which I think is quite nice. It kind of gives it a more rustic feel. The back has just my logo. I tried to keep it simple. So I was really worried at first when I was ordering this that I wasn't gonna know what the quality looked like, because I didn't have time to get a proof so I could see what everything was like before I put in the huge order for 1,500 comics. But I love how this is turning out. Excellent print quality. The resolution looks good. Yeah, this is looking great. There's probably some not safe for work stuff in this book, so keep that in mind. All you kids out there, this book's probably not for you. A little bit of violence. I know people like violence. And of course, the special thank you page for all the 100 people that donated $100 to the Indiegogo campaign. Your name is in this first edition of the book. Now, one thing I was really excited about was that I was able to convince some very talented artists to contribute artwork to the comic. Artists like Death Think, who did this incredible version of Dante and Vern. Anthony Arano, who he did several different versions of Jawless Jake in his very interesting style. James Lee Animation. Not only is he an incredibly talented YouTuber, but he's also an incredible animator and artist. Robin McCammon, who, if you remember, her and her husband, they make a comic of their own called Don't Fear Dawn. Ryan Haddix. Now, he did this on cardboard, so that really makes for an awesome style. Chris Wilson from Cyanide and Happiness. He drew a comic just for my comic. I'll link to all of these artists' profiles in the description. I thank you all. So yeah, overall, I'm very happy with the quality of how this turned out. And this is just part one. I plan on doing, I think, about 7 parts. So this is definitely an ongoing series. And I'm excited to get started on issue 2. So there it is, Requiem of the Crazies. Now, I'm sure you all have a lot of questions. Rusty, why is your hair blonde? I thought you dyed your hair pink. Well, I did. And having pink hair, that's not really for me. So about a week and a half after I dyed it pink, I put some color stripper in there to pull it all out. So I'm back to blonde for now. Second frequently asked question. Rusty, how do I get my own copy of Requiem of the Crazies? So this is the thing. I ordered 1,500, and the reason why I only ordered 1,500 was because if I did make a mistake on this first run, I didn't want to have had ordered way too much, and then I would have wasted a lot of money. So I only ordered just over the necessary amount to fulfill the Indiegogo campaign promises. So that leaves just about, I don't know, maybe 120 to 150 copies of the comic that I'll be able to sell to the general public. So it's gonna be first come, first serve for whoever gets the rest of this print run's inventory. It's gonna take a little bit before I can get more of these comics, because I have to reformat some of the pages a little bit and send them back out to the company Print Ninja. I think it takes up to 8 weeks to have them do all the production and shipping. So it might be about 2 months or so before I have more copies of these that I can put up on the store for everyone else to buy. Now, the main question that I've been getting, Rusty, when am I gonna get my copy of Requiem of the Crazies in the mail? Well, that's an excellent question. And since I'm just one person, I'm shipping all of these out myself.
Here at Rusty Cage Industries, shipping fulfillment has never been more efficient. Step 1 is to individually sign over 1,300 copies of the comic. Step 2, posters. I gotta fold about 550 posters into quad segments in order to make them fit in the shipping bags. Now, I could have paid an undocumented immigrant to do this, but damn it, I just couldn't find any on Craigslist. Step 3. It's time to hand draw 270 individual sketches. There isn't really any rhyme or reason behind what I draw. Most of them are just of ugly people and monsters. And this step takes the longest by far out of all of them. Hey, look at that hideous little fella. And of course, all Indiegogo orders contain a limited edition white avian crux patch.
So now that I have my pile of signed copies, my hand-drawn sketches, my folded poster, and the patch, it's time to put them in a bag. So I have these comic bags that each one will go into along with a comic backboard. Take the drawing, put it in the poster, take the comic, put it on the backboard. Take a bag, put the comic and backboard in the bag. Put the poster in the bag as well. And now I have to individually tape each one.
I really do appreciate everyone's patience having to wait for your order to come in. I don't think that a lot of people realize that I personally package and ship all of my albums, stickers, patches, and comics right out of my house, rather than from some big distribution center with dedicated employees. And let's not forget the 1,200 shipping labels that need to be printed. I haven't crunched all the numbers yet in detail, but shipping alone costs somewhere over $7,000. Once all the labels are printed, it's on to step 7, packaging all the comics and patches into bubble envelopes. Strip it, seal it, slap that label on, and the package is ready to be shipped out. So pretty much, I gotta follow these steps for 1,300 orders, which is probably gonna consume the rest of my life.
It's a living!
Of course, after experimenting with different packaging techniques, I found that slave labor cuts the time in half. Productivity is high, but my floors are littered with shipping trash. Final step, box up all the packages and schedule a pickup. Off to the post office and to your home.
As you can see, it's quite the process, and this is pretty much all I've been doing all day for the past week. So be on the lookout for your package in the mail coming soon. Thank you to all of my backers who helped make this possible. I did not expect that the Indiegogo campaign would reach the financial height that it had. And of course, thank you to all of the viewers who have supported me over the years. On my goofy endeavors, whether it be music or now comic books. So yes, Requiem of the Crazies Part 1 is complete. And for everyone who wants to order a copy, I'll be putting a link in the description of this video.
Well, I realized that even though the Indiegogo campaign has technically ended, you can still make a contribution and get the comic book, along with a custom patch for every order and posters and sketches, depending on your contribution tier. So for now, I think I'm just going to continue selling the comic on Indiegogo through the link below. Once I sell out of this first run, I'll order more books and sell them on my website, so stay tuned for that. Also, a certain fellow YouTuber whose name cannot be mentioned on this website did a review of Requiem of the Crazies. I'll put a link below so you can all go and check that out. Well, anyways, folks, thank you all for watching, and stay tuned for more videos to come.
But Rusty, what the fuck am I supposed to do with a quadded up poster? Does anybody hang up folded up posters on their walls, folks? I would have rather not gotten a poster at all. This is like a slap in the face by Rusty's hard cock.